Good morning, students. Okay, very good morning. So, how are you? Okay, very good. So, first of all, switch off your front camera and mute your microphone, okay? So that the class can be taken quietly. Okay, and you will also follow what I am writing. Today, we'll write the question answer, okay? As you know, this is your science class, so we will continue with the science subject, means chapter number 5. Okay, chapter number 5 is that solid, liquid and gases. Solid, liquid and gases. Okay, all of you must have your book with you and your science notebook, means science copy. You'll write the question answer in the science copy. Okay. So, yes, Rahul, Shruti. Okay, now. So, we have completed the short answer question. No, we have completed short answer question. This is from I am talking about from page number 31 in your science book. Okay,
the one long question. Okay,
we will start from there. Okay, so we have completed, yes, I know, long answer question we have completed one. No, so we will start from number 2. Okay, let us do from 1 again. Okay, some of you may have not written, so I will continue from number 1, then number 2. Okay, see, we will do the long answer question. This is the exercise of the chapter. This is page number 31. Okay, long answer question. Okay, so question number 1, we'll write this one, then number 2, we will go to number 2 then. When sugar is dissolved in water, the volume of water when sugar is dissolved in water, the volume of water remains the same. Why? Okay. Here I am. You cannot see me. I am not visible to you.
Yes, sir.
Yes. No, sir. Why? Okay. As I am writing, I am writing the answer, okay? So, sometimes I may not be visible. The board is visible, okay? So, don't bother about it. I am here. Okay. See, when sugar is dissolved in water, the volume of water remains the same. Why? So, I will write this one again, because I am doing from this one, because only 2 questions are left. Then we will end the class. Okay. So, I will write this one once again. Those who have written, no need of writing, you just check your answer, whether you have written correctly or not, whether any spelling mistakes are there or not, you just check and revise. The molecules in a liquid are not very closely packed. Okay, there are empty spaces among the liquid molecules when sugar is dissolved in water, sugar molecules fill the empty spaces. Please, some of you have not mute your microphone. Please mute the microphone. Okay, some sound is coming. So there are empty spaces among the liquid molecules. When sugar is dissolved in water, sugar molecules fill the empty spaces among the molecules of water. So the water level remains the same, that is, so the water level remains the same, that is, the volume of water, the volume of water does not change. That is, the volume of water does not change. So, completed number one, this one, question answer. So, I will repeat what I have written here. The question is, when sugar is dissolved in water, the volume of water remains the same. Why? The molecules in a liquid are not very closely packed. Okay, that is full stop. Then there are empty spaces among the liquid molecules. That is full stop again. When sugar is dissolved in water, sugar molecules fill the empty spaces among the molecules of water. So the water level remains the same, that is, the volume of water does not change. Okay, understood? This one, this is answer is completed. I have told you once again. Okay, now we will proceed to next question, means the last question of this exercise. How does matter change from one state to another? Okay, before that, I will rub the board now. Okay, this is also a bit long answer. Okay, okay, so we are doing number E, question number 2. Okay, the question is, how does matter change from one state to another? Okay, so you'll write, you'll start writing now. Okay, please mute your microphone. Matter, start writing, everybody should start writing. Okay, please mute, everybody will mute the microphone. Matter can change from one state to another by hitting or by cooling. In other words, states of matter are interchangeable. Hitting makes the molecules move apart and less closely packed while cooling makes the molecules come closer and more closely packed. Solid melts to liquid solid melts to liquid when it is heated. We have seen that one. We have seen that ice changes into water on heating. Solid melts into liquid when it is heated. Liquid liquid changes its state, changes its state, changes its state by heating or by so solid melts into solid melts to liquid when it is heated. Liquid changes its state by heating or by freezing. By heating, liquid changes into gas. By heating, liquid changes into gas. By freezing. By freezing, liquid changes into solid. Liquid changes into solid. Okay, so what I have written, this is completed. I will write one equation there. Equation you will also have to write down or draw. See here, matter can change from one state to another by heating or by cooling. In other words, states of matter are interchangeable. Heating makes the molecules move apart and less closely packed, while cooling makes the molecules come closer and more closely packed. Solid melts to liquid when it is heated. Liquid changes its state by heating or by freezing. By heating, liquid changes into gas. By freezing, liquid changes into solid. So this is completed. I'll write one equation. You will have to write this one. You will write in this way. Solid give ice here we will write heating right melting. Okay. Heating solid. See ice, for example, ice on heating or melting, then cooling or freezing. You write here cooling. Freezing. Okay. Okay. This I will write other way. It is better for you. Okay. here you write cooling or freezing. Okay, this one. Then here you'll write liquid. Okay, liquid. Here you'll write water. In the bracket, you will write water. Okay. Then here you'll write heating, evaporation. Okay. Here you'll write cooling, condensation. Cooling, condensation. Okay. Here you'll write gas. So I have written here solid on heating or melting give you liquid, on heating that evaporation give you gas. Gas, for example, I am writing steam or water vapor. Steam or water vapor. Okay, and see here, this equation you have to give here, this one I will explain this one once again, then I will end the class. So what I have written, matter can change. How does matter change from one state to another state? Matter can change from one state to another by heating or by cooling. In other words, states of matter are interchangeable. Heating makes the molecules move apart and less closely packed, while cooling makes the molecules come closer and more closely packed. Solid melts to liquid when it is heated. This is full stop. Liquid changes its state by heating or by freezing. By heating, liquid changes into gas. By freezing, liquid changes into solid. Okay, now you will give the equation here. Solid, I have written here bracket ice. Here I have written liquid, bracket water, example water. Here I have written gas, example steam or water vapor. You can find this equation on page number 28. If you don't follow this equation, you can see page number 28. Please see, you can see this one. Okay, so solid on heating or melting gives you liquid. Liquid on heating gives you gas. See, gas on cooling gives you water. Okay, or liquid. Liquid on cooling gives you again solid. So this way, ice on heating gives you water. Water on heating gives you steam or water vapor, and water vapor on cooling gives you water, and water on freezing or by cooling gives you ice. This equation you have to write down. Okay, all of you, I think, follow this one. Yes or no? Okay, very good. So this is a very important question also. You must do this properly, okay? So, okay, students, so we have completed our chapter. Exercise also completed, question answer also completed. So in our next class, I will start a new chapter, okay? So till then, goodbye to everyone. Goodbye, everyone. And thank you. Okay, bye-bye.